Hello, YouTube. I back again with the MicroSynth pedal. Just gonna do a little demo here. Got it going through my Fender Twin and playing it through my Stratocaster here. So, thank you. octave really thumps. So trigger determines the input volume at which filter circuits will turn on. If trigger is set too high, the filter may stutter. Okay, so if it's low, difference on the trigger. Maybe I should just start with everything at in the middle. A swell and a reverse delay type sound. So trigger is input volume at which filter circuits will turn on. Sub octave. So sub octave is the sub octave, obviously. It says it only tracks single notes. Guitar is output volume of input signal through the filter. So I guess the more volume you have, the more the guitar is more prominent. Octave, single notes. I'm guessing that's octave up. Square wave, output volume of the square wave. Attack delay, time required for voice signal to reach full volume. Higher number settings can completely remove initial attack of the instrument. Okay. So, resonance is the sharpness, the Q of the filter. So I guess resonance is kind of the wah of the thing. So start frequency. Frequency at which the sweep begins. Stop frequency, the sweep at which it ends. And the rate is the speed that it sweeps from start to end. Okay. And here's some suggested settings in here, I guess. Okay. Auto wah bass, percussive, full synth bass. Huh. Moog. Huh. Okay. Might have to try some of those. Okay, that's really weird because I don't have any. This is totally clean and it's given a distorted tone, so that's kind of cool. So the attack delay is like if you want to get your initial attack, you set it low. And if you want like the swell effect, you set it high. Thank you. added a little tremolo on there. Interesting. Backwards fuzz. So that's all the way up, down, 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 up, about halfway. Oh, I hope this is recording. Resonance is down about right there. Start frequency. This is called backwards fuzz. Here's one called a Moog
Torres pedal, which, so these two, and then I'm gonna have to take these staples out. The way they stapled this, you can't really see the full sheet. Some blank sheets so you could write down your settings. There we go. So that one was the backwards fuzz. So I can kind of show that. And there's that one. I guess you can pause it if you want those settings. So let's try this Moog Taurus pedal setting down all the way up just a hair. Square wave is down a little bit. Tack all the way down. This really does have some cool sounds, though. Triggered the sub octave. Sounds more textured with a delay. Let's try the number two setting. Octave up a little bit. Square wave up a little bit. resonance down a little bit, that all the way down, that all the way up. Sequencer bass. That looks interesting. Sequencer on that. What else do we have? Oh, there's someone here. Mini Moog bass. So, guitar is about 2. Octave is about 1. Okay. Sequential circuit synth. That sounds. That one that I liked. Yeah, I liked that Moog Taurus pedal setting. That one, I liked that one. I think that was the one. Those two. Those Moog Taurus pedal ones, I like those. That one's really loud for some reason. And I liked that fuzz bass one. Thank you. Okay, well, hope that gives you an idea how it sounds. Thanks for stopping by. Please hit the subscribe button. And have a good night. Some of these again because I just realized my trim was still on. So let's go back to the sequential circuits one. These are pretty cool. Backward fuzz. Did I do that one? I think I probably did already. Auto wah bass. Okay. Let's see what an auto wah bass sounds like. This because you can get bass tones out of a guitar. sure there's infinite possibilities with this thing. This would be really good for ambient type work. There's a guy that has a YouTube channel called Chords of Orion, and does some really cool ambient stuff, and that's what I would see this being used in. Something. Maybe dub bass only works if you're playing a bass. Let's see. I think I pretty much tried most of these settings. Did I do the ARP synth bass? This demo video getting too tedious and boring. Pretty much gone through all those, and there's some cool sounds. Just gonna put everything in the middle. Huh. That's one of the coolest sounds yet, and all I did was put it in the middle. Just play around with random patterns. Oh, I could play around with this all night. Well, if you like my videos, please subscribe and have a good night.